No, we are going to see that. Muscles, muscular muscles. What are the muscular muscles? Mainly four muscles are there. Masseter, then temporalis, then lateral pterygoid, and the last one is a medial pterygoid. So what are the muscles? Masseter, temporalis, lateral and medial pterygoid muscles. These are the features of these muscles. Okay. So first one is masseter muscle. Okay, so masseter muscle. How to explain a muscle? So you should have this four headings: origin, insertion, muscle, and action. So origin of the masseter muscle. See, it's a superficial fibers arise from anterior to two-third of lower border of zygomatic arch. See, this is our zygomatic arch. Okay, this is having an upper border. Then in lower border. Between this upper and lower borders, here on the external surface, this is the outer surface. Like that, in the inner aspect, there we are on the inner surface. So it means it is having two borders, upper border and lower border, then outer surface and inner surface. So this, here in this image, we can see the superficial fibers. This arises from this anterior to third of lower border. Correct? This arising from the lower border. Not from the complete lower border, this arising from only the anterior part of the lower border. So superficial fibers arise from anterior to third of the lower border of zygomatic arch. The medial fibers, it is arising from posterior one third. Right about this point. See, main point is posterior one third of lower border of zygomatic arch. Means that this area. Now here we can see the beginning portion of the medial fibers. It is arising from posterior one third of lower border. That also arising from lower border, but it is arising from posterior part of the lower border. Okay, so this arising from lower posterior one third of lower border of zygomatic arch from there it runs down. Then deepest fibers or deep fibers arising from inner surface of, or deep surface means inner surface of the zygomatic arch. What is that? See here I told you these are two surfaces. One is outer surface, the other one is inner surface. Correspond to this outer surface, here we are having the inner surface. So deep fibers arising from the inner surface of the zygomatic arch. So origin is clear. Superficial fibers from anterior to third of the lower border of zygomatic arch. Medial fibers from the posterior one third of the lower border of the zygomatic arch. Deep fibers from the inner surface and the zygomatic arch. Okay, from there these fibers runs down lower and inserted to the angle or inserted to the lateral surface of the foramen. Okay, the angle inserted to the lateral surface of the foramen of mandible. See here, this area is one of the ramus of the mandible. I told you already is having anterior border, posterior border, superior border, and inferior border. Now this having two surfaces. This is the outer surface. And correspond to this outer surface, one more surface is there, that one is an inner surface. Okay. So it is in that masseter muscle is inserted into this outer surface only. Forms of mandible. Okay. So insertion outer or lateral surface. Lateral or outer surface. Okay. So lateral surface of ramus of mandible. Now supply is supplied by anterior division of mandible. Now, what will be the action? See, when this muscle contract, see, it moves the mandible upward. So, elevation of the mandible. Okay. So, these are the features of this masseter muscle. Origin from this roughly, we can say this arising from the zygomatic arch, insertion to the lateral surface of the ramus of mandible. Then, and now supply anterior division of mandible. Now, action to elevate the mandible or upward movement of the mandible. Now, temporalis muscle. It is arising from temporal fossa and temporal fascia. This will be temporal fossa. See, this area, which is seen above the zygomatic arch. So, this area of this one is temporal fossa. And there we can see a fascia, a thin sheet, fibrous sheet, over the temporalis muscle. That is what the temporal fascia. So, most of the fibers arising from this temporal fossa. Some fibers arising from that covering this one is the temporal fascia. Okay, so it is arising from temporal fossa and temporal fascia. See like this. Then it runs downward, deep to the zygomatic arch and inserted to this process of the mandible. This one is coronoid process. Okay, inner surface of the coronoid process. So origin from the temporal fossa and the temporal fascia, insertion, margins and deep surface of coronoid process. Okay, margins and deep surface of coronoid process. About the second one, see the first one is margins and deep surface of the clear. This is the margin. and now to the outer surface, inner surface. Okay, now it is of the coronary process. Now supply, this also supplied by anterior division of mandibular nerve. Now see the action. It elevates the mandible. Anterior fibers elevates the mandible, but the posterior fibers retracts the mandible. How? See, anterior fibers are vertical. So when these fibers contract, it pulls the mandible upward. But see, the posterior fibers turns obliquely forward. Okay, when this muscle fibers contract, it pulls the mandible backward. Okay, this will be the direction of movement. Here, this will be the direction of movement. Okay, so anterior fibers elevates, posterior fibers retracts. So these are two actions. So temporalis muscle is also here. Now lateral pterygoid. Lateral pterygoid is having two heads, upper head and a lower head. Upper head arises from infratemporal surface of later ring of sphenoid. Infratemporal surface and the crest of later ring of sphenoid. What is meant by that? See, this yellow colored one, this is what the sphenoid bone. Okay, see, this one is a greater ring of sphenoid, and this is what the lateral pterygoid plate of sphenoid bone. And here, this lesser, greater ring of sphenoid is having one infratemporal surface, right? Here comes the temporal surface. There, this area which is seen in the temporal fossa. So temporal surface. Now here, infratemporal surface. So upper head is arising from this area. Infratemporal surface of the greater ring. See, greater ring starts from here up to this. See, up to this. This is a greater ring. Starts from here. Okay. So this is the infratemporal surface. This is the temporal surface. Okay, anyway, this one. This is the infratemporal surface. So upper fibers arising from this area, infratemporal surface. And here in the lateral, or here in the junction, there we are having a ridge. That is what the crust. Okay, so from this infratemporal surface and this crust. So upper fibers arising from infratemporal surface and crust of greater ring of sphenoid. Lower head arises from lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate. What is that? See, this is a lateral pterygoid plate. So this surface, this is a lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate. Inner surface, that is a medial surface of the lateral pterygoid plate. Means upper head arises from this area, lower head arises from this area. Now we'll see the right. See upper head. Lower head. Okay, upper head. See, this is what the greater ring here. So infratemporal surface and the crest of sphenoid. Lower head from the lateral surface, lateral pterygoid plate. From there, both fibers run backward and inserted to pterygoid fovea of the mandible. What is that pterygoid fovea of the mandible? See here and then the neck. Anterior aspect of the neck is having a depression. It is not there in this image. See, here in the anterior aspect, there we are having a depression. That is what the pterygoid fovea. Fovea means shallow depression. That fovea for the pterygoid muscle. So it is known as pterygoid fovea. So lateral pterygoid muscle origin and insertion. Okay, not only to the pterygoid fovea, some muscle fibers are inserting to the articular capsule of the temporomandibular joint, and some fibers pierces the articular capsule and reaches the articular disc. Okay, so insertion into three points: pterygoid fovea, articular disc, and a capsule of articular capsule or capsule of temporomandibular joint. Now supply. Here also the same anterior division of mandibular nerve action. It protrudes the mandible. See, when this muscle contract, fibers moves forward along with this mandible, or it pulls the mandible forward. That forward movement of the mandible is known as what? Protrusion. Now, medial pterygoid muscle. This muscle is also having two heads, superficial head and deep head. Okay, superficial head arises from maxillary tuberosity. Deep head arises from medial surface of lateral pterygoid plate. Okay. See here, this roughened area, this projection which is seen behind the third molar. See, this is the upper third molar. Okay, behind that, see here we are having one roughened area. This roughened area is known as a maxillary tuberosity. Okay, this is what the maxilla. Okay, so this tuberosity or the roughened area or the elevation which is seen in this maxilla is known as maxillary tuberosity. So superficial fibers arise from this maxilla, maxillary tuberosity, and runs downward. Okay, then this deep fibers arise from the same lateral pterygoid plate. It all lateral pterygoid plate it is having two surfaces. Now we can see the lateral surface. Now then correspond to this lateral surface on the inner side, that side is as medial surface. Okay, so this deep fibers arise from this inner surface of the lateral same lateral pterygoid plate. Okay, so two heads, superficial head from the maxillary tuberosity, deep head from the lateral pterygoid plate. From there, these fibers runs downward and backward. and insert to this angle of the mandible. See here, this is the angle of the mandible, where inner surface of the angle, now the bone is clear. Okay. See, this is what the angle. Approximately from here, that vibus runs downward and backward, inserted to, not to the outer surface or external surface, it is inserted to the inner or medial surface of the angle of the mandible. Okay, so superficial head from the maxillary tuberosity, clear. This is the maxillary tuberosity. Deep head from the medial surface of the lateral pterygoid plate. Insertion roughened area on the medial surface of angle of mandible, which is inserted to the medial surface of the angle, means that this is what the angle of the mandible, its medial surface. Now supply, now to medial pterygoid. Here one exception is there. See, all masticatory muscles are supplied by anterior division of mandibular nerve, except this medial pterygoid. It is supplied by now to medial pterygoid. It is the branch of main trunk or trunk of the mandibular nerve. Okay, mandibular nerve is dissolving on trunk. Trunk divides into anterior division and posterior division. Okay, see the cursor, dissolving on trunk. Trunk divides into anterior division and posterior division. Okay, see, all other muscles are supplied by this anterior division except this medial pterygoid. It is supplied by the trunk. Trunk use a branch that is a medial pterygoid. Now to medial pterygoid. Action, what will be the action? It elevates and procludes the mandible. See, when this muscle contract, okay, this will be the direction of movement. Means it protrudes and it elevates. Okay, so these are the masticatory muscles. Okay, it may be a shortest question. TMJ, say question.